Hey, how you doing, econ students? This is Mr. Clifford. Welcome to ACDC Econ. Right now, I'm going to give you an overview of macroeconomics and the five key graphs that you need to know. The first and most important graph is aggregate demand and aggregate supply. The concept is pretty simple. The vertical line represents full employment, where we want to be in our economy with 4 to 6% unemployment. This graph shows that the economy can only be in one of three places at any given period of time. It can either be at full employment, it can have a recession, or it can have an inflationary gap. And that's what they'll ask you on a free response, to draw one of those three situations. I made some videos that explain aggregate demand, aggregate supply, and long-run aggregate supply, so go ahead and click here to watch those videos. The second key graph is something called the Phillips curve. Just like aggregate demand and supply, the Phillips curve shows recession, full employment, and inflationary gap. But this time, it's just points on the curve. So down here represents a recession, right here represents full employment, and up here is an inflationary gap. If you want to learn more about the Phillips curve, go ahead and click here to watch that video. The third graph that you need to know is called the money market. This is the supply and demand of money. The reason you need to learn this graph is to understand the idea of monetary policy. The Fed, or the central bank, can increase or decrease the supply of money, and this would change the interest rate. That change of interest rate would affect investment and aggregate demand. Again, that's called monetary policy. The least important graph that you need to know is loanable funds. This is the demand and supply for loans. The vast majority of the time, this graph is used to show the idea of deficit spending. When the government goes out and borrows, it increases the demand for loans, leading to higher interest rates, causing something called crowding out. The last key graph is the foreign exchange market, which shows the international value of different currencies. Always remember that two currencies cannot appreciate or depreciate relative to each other at the same time. In other words, the dollar can't appreciate to the yen at the same time that the yen appreciates the dollar. One will appreciate and the other currency will depreciate. Now, we're not done. There are three free responses on the AP macroeconomics exam. The first question is always very similar. It starts off with aggregate demand and aggregate supply and asks you to draw a recession, inflationary gap, or full employment. Then it usually asks you about some sort of shift or some sort of change in the economy, whether it's an increase in aggregate demand or a decrease in aggregate supply or something happens in the economy. Something they might also ask you to do is draw the whole situation over again using the Phillips curve. So if there's a recession, drawing it with aggregate demand supply or drawing it with the Phillips curve. Then the question might jump into fiscal policy or monetary policy or fiscal policy. Wait, I just said fiscal policy. Of course, that question might continue and ask you about the relative value of a currency because of some sort of change or about something about loanable funds. So that first response is super important, and it's definitely going to have some of those five key graphs that you absolutely need to know. I've actually worked out a bunch of those free responses, and I put them on the videos on my app. So take a look at my AP Macroeconomics Review app on iTunes and Google Play. Till next time.